Welcome back to the Romanian River channel and my playthrough of Mass Effect Andromeda. Episode 14, part 3. Let's see. That way, okay. I suspect we're breaking the game quite hard.
Pathfinder, this area can be mined for resources. You can extract them. Andromeda plant sample detected nearby.
That's interesting. Not what I would have expected.
What's happening here?
Who are you? Is this your datapad? Are you one of them?
Who are you afraid of? Who is them?
Whoever's behind all this. Everyone's acting crazy, spouting all that nonsense. I can't remember how it started. I'm not even sure how I got here.
What do you mean?
Nobody's in their right mind. And there are these people, others. They showed up and they left this datapad.
What did these people want?
If I knew, I wouldn't be asking you. I heard one of them say, we left the datapad behind. Gah! I'm fine now. I'm sorry to trouble you. It was nothing. Be seeing you.
They exhibit unusual brain activity. An outside signal is affecting their thought process.
What can we do for them?
Nothing immediate, though if you scan others, I may be able to locate the source of the signal.
Yeah, playing around with indoctrination, huh? Tin must really be around.
This area can be mined for resources. You can extract minerals via your mining interface.
You're not supposed to.
What the hell are you doing to those people out there?
It's an experiment.
Physically, no harm has come to them. They're fine.
You're doing all this on purpose? Are you insane?
We've been called worse back home.
We used to work for an organization called Cerberus.
Until our boss decided he'd rather spend money on truly crazy ideas like bringing back people from the dead.
Project Lazarus. Pure voodoo.
But in Andromeda, we're our own masters, and what you saw out there, it's the birth of something amazing. A biological network.
A host of minds all linked together, connected. We're harnessing the power of consciousness to create a new kind of supercomputer.
What is Cerberus about?
Purity. We think humanity should chart its own course, free of alien laws or the morality designed to hold us back.
Our boss was straying from the path, lost his focus. He and that Lawson woman were recruiting all the wrong people, friends in low places.
Andromeda is a chance for a do-over. Humanity should call the shots here. The rest can follow our lead.
What exactly is this experiment doing to those people out there?
The right energy focused at the right frequency can entrain a person's consciousness. The mind is ultimately just electromagnetic patterns.
You mean mind control?
Those people were banished. They're criminals. They were using their minds to make trouble anyway. We thought we'd make better use.
And now, by linking them together, they're like a living computer, but working at the speed of thought. Similar to the computer you've got in your head.
What are you doing on Kadara?
The Badlands is a perfect place to do the work that needs to be done. Must be done.
Against all these new threats in Andromeda, it's vital we find an edge for humanity.
Enough of this. Sam?
I've located the control for the signal. It will shut the experiment down.
We can't stop you, but those people depend on the signal now. Their minds need it to function. Leave them be.
How do we shut this experiment down, Sam?
I can tune the signal against the scientists as punishment, freeing the people. The victims will likely suffer complications as a result. Or I can alter the nature of the signal to ease the victim's predicament and lock the system from further changes.
Or I could just walk away and do nothing. Turn the signal against these bastards. Make it hurt.
What did you do? What? What's happening? The river Styx runs through this level of hell, and in it are punished the wrathful and the gloomy. The former are forever lashing out.
At each other piecemeal with their teeth. The latter are gurgling in the black mud, slothful and sullen, withdrawn from the world.
Good.
The river Styx runs through this level of hell, and in it are punished the wrathful. The former are forever lashing out.
At each other piecemeal with their teeth. The latter are gurgling.
Couldn't think of a better solution for those two. If any form of the Reaper survived, such a thing would practically hand humanity over on a silver fucking platter. It's not smart, it's not in any way wise. It's fucking stupid, to be honest. And if anything similar to the Leviathans or the Reaper survive, just corrupting one node fucks everything over.
Pathfinder, this area can be mined for resources. You can extract minerals via your mining interface.
Only kind I do. So we're pointing the wrong way right now. I suspect the cave is the entrance.
High ground. I keep expecting an ambush.
Mountain goating. I have no clue.
Cave over there. Maybe something's inside.
Think that's it?
High levels of toxic gas. Proceed with caution, Pathfinder.
Hey, I'm always cautious.
Smells even worse in here than it does out there.
Close quarters.
To be powering the floodlights.
Well, yeah, but who put it here?
I really hate water on this planet.
Dead end. Huh. Try the other path?
Another generator.
And more lights. They lead to something?
Uranium. Oh yes. And more uranium.
Huh. We're not completely closed in.
What is this place?
You hear that?
Intruders! Stand down. The charlatan wants this one alive. Out for a walk, Pathfinder?
No one else in the collective hesitated to shoot me.
We're a big organization. Low-level operatives might not have gotten the word. But my orders are clear. You're not to be harmed. Crux is in charge here. If you've got questions, talk to her.
Another rebel outpost, so to say.
Not easy building something like that out here.
Always check around. Never know when you run into something. A lot of guys to kill if this thing turns sour.
Pathfinder, you caught me off guard. We don't receive many visitors.
The cesspools put them off?
They are natural deterrents, yes. The Angara call this place Drolir. Translates to death caves. A bit melodramatic. If you've a head for navigation, it's perfectly safe. Like most of Kadara, it's the people you should worry about.
What do you mean?
Someone's been faking the charlatan's orders, giving bad intel. It got two of our recruits killed.
Someone impersonating the charlatan could do a lot of damage.
Only the representatives have access to such high-level information. The boss knows it's someone operating out of this base. It's my job to find the culprit.
So what's the holdup?
The imposter could bolt at the first sign of suspicion. I need a subtle way to smoke them out.
Why would someone risk impersonating the charlatan?
Greed is a powerful motivator, Pathfinder. The collective has access to supplies, credits, you name it. And we only answer to one person.
Maybe I could help. I'm not connected to the collective. A curious outsider would raise less suspicion than an official representative.
That's true. All right, Pathfinder. Here's what we know. The drop point was in the sulfur springs, so the imposter should have high levels of sulfur in their clothes.
Sam's sensors should be able to detect that. Anything else?
We found footprints that could be human or Asari, but too smudged to get an exact size. That's all my intel.
Anyone wanna bet it's the chick at the door?
Sulfur levels are on the high side. But not by a large percentage.
And she's Asari, which fits her footprint bill. Can't rule her out yet.
She's worth further investigation. Sulfur levels are normal.
Not our culprit, then.
This plant is highly noxious, Pathfinder.
Damn. I was hoping for Helia's version of tulips.
The collective. Sulfur readings are low. Additionally, Angaran feet are distinct from humans and Asari.
Can't hurt to check.
I'd kill for some
high sulfur levels, but the footprints at the drop site contradict a Salarian's webbed feet.
Just being thorough, Sam.
Not really being stupid.
Sam, what's inside the cages?
Judging from the scratching.
Sam, what are they doing with the Adhi?
It appears the Collective are attempting to domesticate the creatures.
And how's that going?
Aggression levels are lower than what we've seen in the wild, but I wouldn't recommend opening the cage. Sulfur levels are high. Her footprints are of a similar shape to those left at the drop site.
Could be our rat.
Before accusing Dorado, perhaps you'd like to talk to her. She could have an alibi.
Need something? Go bother Crux.
You're a testy one.
Sorry. Haven't slept in 36 hours, thanks to another shit job.
36 hours? That can't be healthy.
Defying the charlatan's orders isn't healthy. I go where I'm told.
You've never been tempted to manipulate your boss's orders?
What? What do you mean?
You know, fudge the intel, use the Collective's resources to make a profit on the side.
I don't know what you're playing at, but I'm done talking to you.
Dorado's heart rate spiked when you questioned her about the charlatan's orders.
The lady doth protest too much, methinks.
Sorry about before, not much traffic down here. Recruits are jumpy.
You didn't shoot. That's all that matters.
You're awfully good-natured about people pointing guns at your face. Some of us have been down here for months. I haven't seen the sun in weeks.
Weeks? Seriously?
I'm one of the few people who know how to operate the water filters. I've been trying to train a backup, but most recruits can't stand the smell. Not many volunteers. I'd better get back to work. Thanks for the chat.
What do you think of Lynx, Sam?
Her explanation for the level of sulfur in her clothes was plausible, Pathfinder.
Heading out again? Not for a bit.
Almost too plausible. Hopefully we can ask details.
Pathfinder, any luck finding the imposter?
Dorado's clothes showed high levels of sulfur. When I questioned her loyalty to the charlatan, she became frantic.
You asked her outright. I said to be discreet. Aquila, detain Dorado.
Dorado? She's gone. Said it was on the charlatan's orders.
Damn it. If the charlatan finds out, I let her get away.
I'll take care of it. She can't have gone far.
Really, Dorado? Really?
She ambushed me. I had no choice but to take her out.
Would have liked to question her. but at least it's done. Thanks, Pathfinder.
Nice. Trying to make a fight of it with a Pathfinder. Stay down, you piece of shit. Okay, via that way.
Hostiles ahead! The Exiles have quite a setup over there. Won't be happy to see us.
Detect no sign of Mr. Vidal, Pathfinder. Shall we proceed without him?
That's not... Don't move. Were we too loud?
Shut up. Pharaoh will deal with you.
I don't need to tell you what happens next.
You're gonna try to kill me and my friends. I've got a few questions first.
No. You'll bleed, just like the others.
So it's true. You murdered innocent people.
Invaders and sympathizers are not innocent. I will protect my home.
Don't let your hate poison you. We can coexist.
Like here on Kadara. Sloane lies to my people and uses them for power.
I'm not Sloane.
You are all the same.
Not so fast.
You're late.
I've got a good reason. You'll see in three...
Don't just stand there!
Two...
Kill them!
Still mad?
Die!
clean out these animals. Check everything. That's one.
Logs prove they came here for recruits, then started killing the locals.
And now they're dead. Don't you love a happy ending?
No, they would deserve to suffer even more. My opinion of fanatics isn't that good, if you can tell. I get protecting your own people and shit like that, even culture and stuff like that. But going beyond that point to murder-fuck other people, not my deal.
The streets of Kadara are safe again. You did good, Ryder. Don't worry. I'll let all the important people know who to thank.
Maybe the exiles will see the initiative in a new light.
Anything's possible. Admit it, some of that was fun.
Some of it.
I knew it. You're all right. Don't be a stranger, Pathfinder.
Nice. I'll go drop that and call it for this episode, because we are at 35 minutes. Well, not this episode, this part of the episode. Sorry. Or actually, technically speaking, you should also end the episode.
Automated protocols activated. Deploying forward station.
Huh. Good way to end, wouldn't you think?
Mining zones have been added to your nav system, Pathfinder.
Armored blocks. good way to end, I think. So yeah, thank you for watching, ladies and gentlemen, and until next time, buff the...